This is Mel Wolverson from IT Training at the University of Missouri. Let me show you how to make custom bullets in InDesign. Here we have the bullets of boredom, which is just the blah default bullets and font. And below we have some bullets of interest, which we are going to learn how to make. And this will work for any web ding or any font symbol, really. So here we go. First, you'll want to select the text that you want to change the bullets of. So I'll just highlight these four basic bullets. Then I'm going to go up to the top right-hand corner of the screen and choose the panel menu. From that panel menu, I'm going to go down towards the bottom and choose bullets and numbering. That's where you can adjust your bullets and numbering. Now here you can see the bullet characters that I have used recently. And you can see that once you've chosen one, it does appear in your recently used, and you can use it again. You don't have to go out and find it again. So that's kind of nice, but let me show you how to find them in the first place. Alright, I'm going to, from this dialog, click Add over on the right-hand side. And that's going to take me to a large list of bullets in the font family that I am currently in for the regular text. But what I want to do is I want to search for either webdings or wingdings. Those are the built-in symbols, and there are a ton of them. So if there's anything that you are looking for, it's probably there. Ears, arrows, copy, paste icons, locks, faces, figures, hands, all kinds of fun stuff. So here we have wingdings 2, and I am going to choose just an interesting flourish from that set, and I'll click Add to add that to my recently used list so I can find it again, and then I'll click OK to go ahead and add that in. So then I select it in the major dialog and say OK to confirm and close out of the dialog. And then deselect. That's all there is to creating a custom font for your bullets. One of the benefits of using this method of changing your bullets, rather than convert your bullet to text or things like that, is that you can just hit enter and add another bullet very easily. It keeps the same font, it keeps the same style, and this can also be added to a paragraph style. So you could apply this throughout your document and even use it, if you wanted to, in multiple different documents. Thank you for joining me. Again, I'm Mel Wolverson with IT Training. Click below to subscribe or visit training.missouri.edu to see our live classes and full range of training content.